been a week since I got the 2021 MacBook Pro M1 Max 32 core, 32 gigs of unified memory and 1 terabyte, that's the base model. And it's been a week since I had this reaction.
Holy shit, like this caught me by surprise.
And in this video, I will update you on my thoughts on this device as a creative, as a filmmaker, as a video editor, answer a bunch of your questions, run a few more render tests so that you can decide if this device is something for you, if you want to put an order in, if you want to cancel your pre-order, whatever it is, it's up to you. Also, I just got my very first Apple Watch, the Series 7, so you can totally see me right now transforming it into an Apple fanboy. So the first thing that jumps into my eye every time I open this device, especially compared to my 2018 MacBook that I'm still using, is not the notch, no, but it's actually the screen real estate. It is noticeably bigger, it feels more immersive, it is more fun to actually watch something on it, be it a YouTube video, a movie, or edit my videos. Also tied to that is, again, I mentioned it in my first video, and that's the audio quality that comes out of these speakers. It's more rich, it's more bassy, and that helps actually with your video edit. So talking about editing, I actually edited the full 18-minute review of the M1 Max on this device, and it blew my mind because it enabled me to do things that I was never able to do before. Major change for me was that I was able to edit this entire project in the original media without any proxies in better quality mode without any problem. It's super smooth. Even when I lay it on LUTs and 2 video frames and a screen recording, no matter what I threw at it, it was fine. Except when I actually added some 3D animation text on it and still had my Komodo footage and had some grades on it. That's when it stuttered just a little bit, but like it made editing so much more smooth that I really, really enjoyed it. And this for me is like really the reason why I got this device, so that as me as a video editor, I can do these kind of things and have actually a way more enjoyable and smooth video editing experience. In particular, also like pulling up LUTs, adding effects, booting up the system and just adding any layer of like an adjustment layer or dragging in footage. It just, everything just happens almost instantaneously, which previously for me sometimes meant that I had to wait for a minute or two. And so overall, it really made my editing process much faster. Also, the export of this 18-minute 4K project took me about 15 to 20 minutes, I didn't time it, to export and render. And that leads me to a question that has been going around and has been vigorously discussed, and this is, do you need an M1 Max or is the M1 Pro fine? Now, from what I've gathered, and I've only one device, so I can't do a side-by-side test, but what I've heard is that the M1 Pro in most instances is equal to the M1 Max, especially when it comes to photo editing, basic video editing. You should be fine with the M1 Pro, though when you go into some serious video editing, the M1 Max seems to be still the champion here, especially when it comes to the encoding and decoding. One of the questions I had in my last video, and I just got confirmation from one of you guys in the comments, is that if only the 16-inch model has the high power mode, if you need to boost some computing power to your machine, it's only possible on the 16-inch M1 Max model, not the 14-inch. So in case you're between the two, get the bigger one to enable the high power mode. Now, one point that you made very clear in the comments is that some of these editing programs may have performance issues if they are being watched, like by a screen recording. Now, what I did is re-ran the render test of the 30-second 8K Redcode RAW R3D vRaptor footage to see if the performance was inhibited due to the screen recording on Final Cut Pro, Premiere Pro, and Resolve. Now, drum roll. Premiere Pro stayed the same at 3 minutes 54, a second faster than before, but pretty much unchanged without screen recording. Great. Well, whatever. It's still a good export time. But you all pointed out that particularly Resolve has some issues there when being watched. And so I exported it again and we landed at 2 minutes and 54 seconds. That is about a minute faster than with screen recording. So yes, you were all right. Resolve is fast. Resolve is also faster than Final Cut Pro. I made a mistake. I accidentally exported the Final Cut Pro video in ProRes, and there it only took 47 seconds. But if I export it as H.264 like the other clips, it takes 3 minutes and 16. So yes, Resolve is faster than Final Cut Pro on this machine to export the same clip, roughly the same clip, and Premiere clocks in just 40 seconds slower than Final Cut Pro. In the previous video, I was also bashing the R5 8K footage a lot because it was not playing back smoothly. Again, people have pointed out that screen recording may have been an issue. I'm looking at it right now, still choppy. I have a LUT and two LUTs on it and grain. So if I remove that, nope, still choppy. So again, R5, 8K, all eye footage. I mean, everything else is working perfectly fine. So it must be this weird 8K codec that Canon has. Now, last but not least, I want to quickly touch on the handling of this device. The weight is very similar. I've not had an issue. I've not carried it in a backpack yet. Well, I actually did. Carried it in a backpack was not a big problem. One thing that I really enjoy about it as well, and again, this is just like a 1 week test, is the battery life. I keep this thing oftentimes unplugged for a couple of hours and edit in it. So I think I would say like 3 to 4 hours of Final Cut Pro editing you can get in one battery load at the very least. Now, I was not planning on making this 1 week update video, but because you had so many questions, I thought like there's critical mass. So if you keep commenting below, if you have more questions, let me know down. If you want me to render specific things, I can try to do that. If we get another critical mass, I may just upload another one, or maybe we just do one of these short videos, these vertical things. We'll see. But there's certainly more coming on this channel. Can't share what, but it's super exciting. Stay tuned for that. Subscribe, hit that notification bell, leave a like if you enjoyed this video. If you haven't watched the full review yet and my first reaction to it and all the Retina tests that I've been referencing, check the video out right here. And as always, thanks so much for watching. Have a good morning, have a good night, whenever and wherever you are around this beautiful planet. Bye bye.